Welcome, everyone. This is the second installment of a series of short interviews that we're doing pertaining to the BTP certification program. So I'm Andrew Lundy with the partner organization, and I have here with me my colleague, Dennis Van Kempen, who's going to talk to us a little bit about the integration suite certification. So with that, tell us a little bit about the integration suite and why it's a great idea to be certified in it.
Yeah, well, thank you for the invitation once again, Andrew. The integration suite, most of you of working with SAP technology know it's been around for quite some time. Obviously, before there was cloud, there was already integration. If you have your SAP environment, your SAP systems, there's always going to be, for any enterprise, other systems around where you want to have connections, so to third-party systems. But even within the SAP technology stack, there's been acquisitions over time, and so there's always been a need for integration. And that could be your data integration, so then you're really literally talking about your bits and bytes, which then you go into the world maybe also of the data warehousing, your ETL tooling, but specifically more for SAP, also process integration. So you're working at a higher level at the application stack, and you're doing things in your customer relationship management environment that you want to replicate over to your HR environment, etc. So you're doing more business processes and replication. So those things have been around for many decades. And SAP had previously, or at least for the on-premises world, I shouldn't say previously, but for the on-premises world, they worked on the NetWeaver stack. You had a SAP PO process integration, and there are different tools around for data integration. And one of them came with the business objects acquisition, SAP data services. Now, obviously, when things moved into the cloud, there had to be also a product to integrate those cloud products. And that, again, that goes on multiple levels. You want to integrate your on-premises environment with the cloud, right? But you also have those different cloud products you want to integrate, maybe SAP Ariba, SAP SuccessFactors. Today, of course, a lot will be SAP S/4HANA Cloud, and integrate all those products. So that is what the integration suite does. It's been around for many years, also the cloud version, and the same goes for the certification. I think it was introduced, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think around maybe 2017, 2018, around that time, so several years. Now, the good news is that as of second last year, as with the other business technology platform certification, all the training material you need to get certified on the integration suite is available for free. So it's no longer necessary to sign up for an SAP training course online, or maybe even have to travel to do the on-site training, which obviously quite a bit of budget is needed. Now you can just do everything online. And to promote that, at the SAP HANA Academy, we've been asked to do a number of video tutorial series, how to get certified. And I completed this series, I think back in March, April, which you can view on the HANA Academy YouTube channel. And as of recently, they're also published as micro learnings on the open.sap.com website. And I think we'll do the URLs in the show notes, so it should be easy for you to find. Now, before I continue with the whole certification and how it works, maybe Andrew, there's things I've missed or I wasn't really clear to put in?
No, there's a lot going on there. I guess one question I have, is it fair to say that Integration Suite really kind of acts to harmonize the disparate sort of types of systems that you're likely to want to integrate into BTP? Does it help kind of give you a more consistent sort of application interface? Is that the primary intent, or help me kind of understand a little further?
Not necessarily in the terms of the UI, but it's definitely for data and business processes to bring those together. And it's been one of the oldest components or services that were included with what was previously called the SAP Cloud Platform. And now it's definitely a core piece, a core center technology of the business technology platform. But let me show you, if I share my screen.
No, that's great that as you're pulling that up, it's great that there's so much readily available information and training kind of in the lead up to getting certified for Integration Suite. So we see here on your screen the Discovery Center. So what's that about?
Yeah, the Discovery Center is the one place to go if you want to learn or get information about any service that's being hosted on the business technology platform. They present missions, which is a bit like the tutorials you find on the SAP Developer Center. Here I'm interested in the service catalog, which the whole list of services. And the reason why I'm showing you this is because we have, it's listed here as the capabilities.
Right.
We have the integration, database and data management, and the solution. So we have our integration solution. And we see there are a couple of, well, what's it, 10, 11 services listed. And one of them is the integration suite. So there are multiple products that are involved in integration, which have, for example, the event mesh or SAP Graph, master data integration, or even SAP Data Intelligence, but those are not part of the certification. For the certification, we only care about this piece here. And that shows what's called, here they call it tools. In other material, it's called capabilities, but these are the four core pieces of the integration suite. One is the cloud integration. That's, I would say, the most central piece. It's mainly SAP technology, and it's sort of the cloud version of what we have on the SAP NetWeaver process integration product. Then there are pieces called Open Connectors, which, as we'll see, is a third-party tool. It's also been part of the suite for a long time, but it's not technically SAP technology. And there's one API management, which is the same for it. It comes from the API, the Apigee product. Now, you won't really see the technology is from a third party because it's all, you know, it's the same look and feel, etc. But sometimes you get a little different UI, and so that's the thing. The most questions will come from cloud integration. If we switch now to the new learning.sap.com website launched at TechEd last year with all the free training mentioned, and select this Get Certified link. Here we have all the certifications listed, and the list is actually, every time I look, there's new certifications added. For example, just recently, there are a couple of Ariba certification have been added. So also for those cloud solution, it's free training, excellent stuff. And here is the Certified Development Associate Integration Suite. So it's a development associate certification, which also indicates that some of the questions, I really assume you have hands-on knowledge with the suite. So if we go here, it's just an overview page. It shows you for the certification, get 80 questions, 3 hours, which typically is more than enough, and a link to the sample questions. If I open that, let me just open it up. If I open that here in a new tab, it only has a couple of questions. We can go through it, but maybe six or five. Whatever, so five. So this doesn't really test whether you are ready to take the exam. It doesn't really assess your knowledge for five
questions. But it gives you a flavor of it.
But it shows you exactly how the certification online will look like. It's exactly the same UI. It's exactly also the type of questions. If you've done maybe a Microsoft or a Google certification before, typically there's a lot of text. Those are like really text heavy questions. And for those maybe a little less fluid in English, that can be a big challenge. Here with SAP certifications, they're very simple. It's a simple question and simple answers, and just a radio button, you know, and you can click what you think the answer is. If you can't read it, you know, you can make it a little bit bigger. There's a assessment navigator, which shows you where you are. So this is the whole UI of the exam experience. It's exactly like this. Now, let me close this again. and we can leave this. And then what's important is the topic areas. So these are the topic areas that will be part of the exam. There's only five areas. As I mentioned, well, there's a part that's about fundamentals that explains, you know, how does it work, the business technology platform, how does it work, the integration suite. And they, here we have those four tools I mentioned: API provisioning, process APIs, model extensions, and the integration advisor. And so these are the same four tools we find here are back on the topic areas. Now, besides this, we don't really have a lot of information on the kind of what you need to know. And again, with some other vendors, topic areas will be a long list of topics you're expected to be familiar with. With SAP, it works kind of differently because all the information you need to know is in the course for the training that's part of the certification. So here, like I mentioned, it's online, it's freely available. And here you can go through all these, the fundamentals. So that's one of the topic areas, API provisioning, and it tells you exactly what you need to know. So it's sort of in a step mode. And then you can go to the learning and read those, read the information you need. There'll be a couple of exercises in some of the couple of videos in some of the training. And at the end, a quiz to assess your knowledge. So that's how the preparation works. And just as an add-on, what we did for the academy is, you know, digest this material into a video format and focus on the essentials, so the things you really need to know in a differently consumable format, you know, if you're on somewhere commuting or you know, whatever preference you have for taking online courses. So that's basically what I wanted to show here about the integration suite, Andrew.
Great, Dennis. You know, sounds like it's well contained, and like you said, the number of topics here isn't too many to kind of grasp onto at once, and maybe a good one to get started with for those that are interested in getting their certification. So yeah, I'd like to thank you, Dennis, for giving us a little rundown there. And I appreciate that. Also, as Dennis mentioned, if you forget and don't have it handy, the HANA Academy is very easy to find in YouTube. Just type in SAP HANA Academy and you will find it right away. Also, remember that you have access to the whole SAP community. It's a lot of blogs, there's articles and other resources. Don't be afraid to go look around for those. We're here to support you as a community. And once again, thank you, Dennis, for that brief overview. And we will be back in future episodes to talk about some of the other certifications. So we'll see you all soon. And thanks so much for joining.
Thanks for listening. Thanks, Andrew.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye.